Hey, what's up guys? Will here for GSM Arena. Android 11 has been out for a little while, but now it's coming to Samsung phones, along with their newest UI, One UI 3. It's rolling out first to their higher-end models in the Note 20 and the S20 series, but it'll make its way to the other models pretty soon. So what's new here? Let's go over some of the most notable changes you'll find in One UI 3. We'll start off with some cosmetic changes you'll find when browsing the UI. Subcategories listed in the settings menu are better spaced out and easier to read. And from the settings search bar, recent searches appear as bubbles now instead of in a list. You can even make a search via hashtag if you wanted to. Pulling down the notification shade will cover the whole screen. You won't see the home screen under it. And we should mention that quick toggles are easier to edit too. You can do this from the notification shade itself. The volume control panel has been revamped, now with 4 vertical sliders instead of horizontal ones. The phone dialer has some cosmetic changes too. You can pick a layout for your in-call screen. And you can choose a background image or video for this screen as well. You can only have one image though, not different ones for each contact. As far as Samsung's own apps go, the most noticeable changes will be found in the gallery. You now get a film strip of tiny thumbnails on the bottom of the screen when looking at a photo for easier navigation. And swiping up on the photo will reveal a cleaner interface now with related photos, but with the unfortunate downside that the photo's technical details are now buried in a submenu. And finally, there are plenty of features from Android 11 that have now been integrated into Samsung's UI. One of these is notification history, which you can activate in settings. If you miss a notification by accidentally deleting it, you can find it again here. Messenger apps can now appear in a round bubble overlay, which makes for easier multitasking. If you've used Facebook Messenger with its chat heads, this should be quite familiar. There's also an option called Smart Pop-up View, which we've actually seen working in Android 10. This lets notifications from other kinds of apps show up in floating bubbles too, but for now it doesn't seem to work with the new UI. Android 11 brings new media controls. These appear just below the quick toggles, and you can swipe to quickly switch between different media apps that you have running. Another improvement that comes with Android 11 is the ability to pin your favorite apps to the top of your share options. This way they'll appear in the same order every time, saving you from having to hunt for them. And permissions are handled differently now too. You get a new prompt for permissions every time an app requests it. You can deny, allow only while using the app, or allow just for one time. If an app requires constant access to permission, you'll need to provide this through an option in settings. And permissions for apps that have not been used for a longer time are auto-revoked. So there you have it guys. One UI 3 has a lot to bring to Samsung users and is not only cosmetic. There's a lot to gain from implementing Android 11's new features too. Thanks for watching, stay safe, and see you on the next one.